two guests have joined us. Katie Brand is here, but two other guests.
Yeah, I can see.
Katie on the table. Guess which show they're both in, Katie.
Guess which show?
Yeah, guess which West End show these two are in.
Oh, I'm looking at them as a young boy and an older boy.
Young boy looks like he might...
Is it Mamma Mia? I think it might be Billy Elliot. I'm going to put that
it's
out there.
It's Billy Elliot.
So we're joined by two Billy Elliots. We have Scott McKenzie. Scott, good afternoon. Scott, hello. Sorry. Hello, Scott. Good afternoon. And Barnaby Meredith. Hello there, Barnaby.
Hello.
So we have the younger and the older Billy Elliot. Scott, hello. How old are you?
I'm 13 years old.
You're 13 years old. And how long have you been in Billy Elliot?
I've been in Billy Elliot for 6 months now.
Been in for 6 months. And how are you enjoying it?
It's just brilliant.
Is it? And you're Scottish?
Yeah, I'm Scottish.
And I believe you are only the second Scottish person to play Billy in the West End.
Yeah, I'm only the second one. And the other one, the first one, was actually one of my friends at stage school.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
Okay.
What a coincidence.
What a terrific role that is as well. It's not embarrassing to admit, Katie. I have seen Billy Elliot, the West End musical. Don't know why I threw a pen on the floor.
No, but I did. That was for emphasis.
I have seen Billy Elliot, the West End musical, 4 times.
Wow.
How many times have you seen it, Katie Brand?
I've seen the film, and actually...
In the film.
An old family friend of mine used to be the older Billy Elliot in the production.
And
as
you
well.
Still couldn't
know,
be
I'm
bothered.
Awful. That's how bad I am.
That is sickening.
Listen, you know, if the constant media whirlwind would give me one evening off, I'd be able to go and see Billy Elliot.
And Barnaby, you play the older Billy Elliot.
Yes, that's right.
And so you're in the production at the moment.
Yep.
And how old are you?
26.
You're 26. And explain, with the older Billy features in the production, is that when he is imagining the Swan Lake dance? Is it that scene?
Kind of, yeah. It's a bit different from the film, where he just appears at the end. I come in about halfway through the second act as a kind of dream, a vision of what Billy would like to be when he grows up.
How he would dance.
Yeah, kind of. And we just do like a dance together and a pas-de-deux, and there's also a flying section. So
a bit on wires.
Yep. Yeah.
But it is Swan Lake, isn't it? It's a musical.
Yes, Swan Lake, the music, yeah.
In that
yeah.
scene. And Billy Elliot now, the musical, has opened, I think, all over the world.
Yeah.
When it opened on Broadway, it got more Tony nominations than any other... Craig, you're back, the managing director of England. You've got more nominations, isn't it, I think, than any other musical in history.
Yeah, phenomenal success.
Yeah. It's a really, really good show. And what I like about it, the film is terrific, but actually, the stage production, it's a bit angrier than the film. Do you know what I mean by that?
Yeah,
in terms of the politics and the sort of young man's dream sitting side by side with this community in decline?
Yeah, definitely. I think the show shows a lot more of the political side and... how hard Billy's life was at that time and all that sort of stuff.
There's more depth and passion to it.
Yeah, I agree with you, Scott. There is a lot more depth and passion to it.
I've always wondered, is there still an issue with young boys telling their fathers that they want to be ballet dancers? Is that something that still exists?
I think so,
I think there is,
unfortunately.
But less and less, because of the Billy Elliot factor has been really important for ballet, for boys
absolutely.
In ballet, making ballet seem cool. It's really important.
Was it, Scott, amongst your friends, did they find it strange that you took up ballet?
No, not really. I think they were just really supportive. They thought it was actually quite cool because of all the different roles that are on the line, and they saw quite a lot of movies that involve ballet, so they were quite interested
in that. So that's how things have changed. Yeah.
Proximity to girls as well, as always.
Cool.
Girls not wearing very much and getting quite sweaty. That's always...
Yeah, all the little skimpy tutus.
Yeah. All right, how old are you?
13.
We're going to take the news and come back. We'll talk more with Scott, more with Barnaby. Katie Brand is here. We're live at the English National Ballet. So, welcome back to the English National Ballet, the headquarters in southwest London in Kensington. We bring you a ballet special on the programme today. It's Wednesday. We'll still be doing the moaning. That moaning will be coming from the English National Ballet with none other than Comedy Dave from the BBC Radio 1 Breakfast Show, who's just joined us and is in the corner of the studio. Hello there, Dave.
Hello, Richard. How are you?
Yes, I'm excellent, thank you.
Good.
Have you been here before?
Would you believe no?
Have you ever seen any ballet production?
Well, my daughter does ballet, but she's 3.5.
Yep.
So I've never seen anything... I guess, as proper as this. But this whole building is just full of ballet people all lying around looking lithe and beautiful, isn't it?
It is. It's probably Craig Hassel. This is Craig. He's the boss here. He's a managing director of the English
Craig.
National Ballet.
Hello. Can't dance.
Have you never danced?
Never.
And how did you become the MD, then, of the English National Ballet, if you hate ballet?
As a conspiracy, I don't know.
You hate ballet.
Slightly put some words in
your mouth. I love ballet. I just can't do it.
But, you know, Dave's right there, that you, when you come here, you come here to enter just a little world, a strange and intriguing and fun little world where in these rehearsal rooms are exactly as you would imagine, with the upright piano in the corner and the balance bars and the mirrors everywhere. But in the corridors, there are people, these dancers just lying around, either stretching themselves or snacking.
Can you imagine how people like us feel? We feel really old and fat.
And you have to step to get anywhere in this building, you have to literally step over ballet dancers.
Step over bodies.
Step over
literally.
Bodies.
It's like fame, isn't it? Yeah. Do you not think it's a bit like fame?
Yeah, but better.
I think it's more that fame is a bit like this.
I think you're probably right.
Yeah, you're right.
I think this came first
No, good point, made.
No, the whole discipline of ballet was invented
as
a reaction to fame.
As a supporting industry for fame.
Katie Brand is here, the comedian, is a big fan of dance and was on Let's Dance for Comedy Relief. Comedy Dave was until recently on Dancing on Ice, so a sort of dance connection.
Well, I assume that you had me here, obviously, because my extensive knowledge of dance and ice-based performance.
Yes.
Is that why?
That was it, yeah.
Yeah, okay, yeah. And I'm available.
Your majesty on the ice is why we have you here.
Thank you.
But also, of course, Dave is here for the moaning. So that's coming later. Get off your mind, whatever you fancy. Call now. The lines are open. 0500 909 693. What has been winding you up? What has been irritating you? The example I used earlier, and I think it's worth repeating. This did irritate me, Katie.
Go on.
I got stuck behind two people in Starbucks ordering a no-water soya chai tea latte.
What?
And it took so long to make. I was 10 minutes late for a meeting. And my thought is, if you're going to order that, you don't like coffee, get out.
Or at least do it in off-peak times.
Yeah.
Go into Starbucks and order an empty cup with a straw. That's what I think it's going to come to.
And no water? How do you have a no-water coffee?
I don't know.
So whatever's been irritating you, 0500 909 693. Still with me here, we have Scott McKenzie, who is... at 13, and plays Billy Elliot at the moment. And Scott, how many Billys are there at any one time? Because you rotate, don't you?
Yeah, there are 4 Billys at the moment, and there's 3 in London, and one of them's at home on their break, and that rotates.
And we have a question for you, Scott, that has come in. My question for Scott McKenzie, brackets Billy Elliot. Billy is such an emotional show in all respects, with constant highs and lows. How do you prepare yourself for the emotional scenes? And do you prefer when you can portray Billy's emotions through the dance numbers in the show rather than through dialogue?
You have to think of things in your head, and that gets you set up for the emotional scenes. And to express it through dance, you have to use the movement to create the expression.
So you think in your own head of things that either make you happy or sad or whatever emotion you might be.
Yeah, there's loads of different emotions that you have to think of.
That's really interesting. And Barnaby Meredith is here, who plays the older Billy Elliot in a scene where Billy imagines what he's like when he's older and dances a scene from Swan Lake. What do you think, Barnaby, for those that have only seen Billy Elliot the film, what do you get, what does dance bring to the story of Billy Elliot? What is conveyed particularly effectively through dance in that show, do you think?
I think everything, really. Because there's so many different numbers in the show, where, you know, it follows a story that the film follows, obviously. But every now and again, there's a big dance number where Scott or whoever it is on the stage gets to express how they feel through dance. So it plays a huge part in the show.
And so he's set against a miners' strike, and there's a brilliant scene where I think Billy just found out that his family don't want him to go down to London to the Royal Ballet. Mm-hmm. And you're really frustrated, and you're dancing, I think, against police with riot shields. Say again.
Angry dance.
It's called the Angry Dance.
At the end of Act One, yeah.
And so that, I think dance is very effective in that scene because you're conveying those emotions through dance and sort of punching and kicking these riot shields. I think that's quite a good example of what you get from the stage production that you wouldn't get from the film.
Yeah, it's about one boy against the world, really.
And get up with a nice email here, Scott. This is from, I'll tell you who it's from in a moment. I'm listening on my computer and I'm the very proud auntie of Scott McKenzie. May Barr.
Oh, thanks, Anthony.
bacon at bbc.co.uk. You can text 85058. So here's one of the numbers from Billy Elliot, one of the, I think, most famous songs from the musical. It's called Electricity.
It's a bit like being angry. It's a bit like being scared. Confused and all mixed up and mad as hell. It's like when you've been crying and you're empty and you're full, but I don't know what it is, it's hard to tell. It's like that there's music playing in your ear, but the music is impossible, impossible to hear. But then I feel it move me like a burning deep inside. Something burst in me wide open, impossible to hide. And suddenly I'm flying, flying like a bird, like electricity, electricity.
So that was Electricity from the musical Billy Elliot. We're live at the English National Ballet, a ballet special this afternoon on 5 Live. Scott McKenzie is here, who plays Billy Elliot, who's one of the Billy Elliots at the moment. So you're from Dumbarton, just outside Glasgow.
Yeah.
And presumably you have to do the Geordie accent.
Yeah, it's quite hard, but there's a lot of similarities between the Scottish accent and the Geordie accent.
Are
like
there?
E.g. vowels and stuff like that.
Which words are similar?
Don't look at me.
No, I don't know. You don't have to speak. You just do a dance. And also, you've got to sing in the Geordie accent.
Yeah.
That must be an enormous challenge.
Well, we have dialect coaches come in and teach us how to speak the Geordie accent and how to, like, round the mouths off and stuff like that.
Was that one of the more daunting parts of getting the job, having to get that right?
Yeah, because I was thinking, oh, God, how on earth am I going to do a Geordie accent?
Let me have a look at some more texts that are coming in. I'm a huge fan of the show, and I've seen it many times as Billy Elliot. I've also been lucky enough to see Scott in the role twice and believe he is extremely talented.
Oh, that's
how about
nice.
That? 85058, bacon at bbc.co.uk. Let me just go back to Craig Hassel, who's the managing director here at the English National Ballet. Actually, Scott, you're 13 now, you're in Billy Elliot. What is your ambition? Would you like to become a full-time dancer?
Yeah, I would love to become a principal dancer for the English National Ballet. And my dream role is to be Romeo in Romeo and Juliet.
Oh, great. I would love
to do that.
This actually is looking a bit like a job interview here at this desk.
Well, there's a Romeo right behind you. Max was a Romeo, so we'll talk. Hey. Ask what it takes. Yeah.
There we go. Max could be your mentor. Max is going to give us a little dance demonstration shortly, which, of course, will work brilliantly on the radio. It's made for an audio-based medium. Would you be interested in Scott working here, coming here?
Well, happily, I don't choose the dancers. Oh. That's Wayne Eagling's job. But I would choose you because you seem very grown up for your age, and it's a great show. So if you can do Billy Elliot, you're on the right track, I think, to being a ballet dancer.
On the text, actually, I was at a text that I read out earlier. It was from Anne in Hampshire, Craig, and you weren't here, but she said, why are there so few British dancers in British ballet companies? And I was watching the documentary on BBC Four last night. It's called Agony and Ecstasy,
I think, isn't it? Right.
Which is a year in the life of the English National Ballet, English in the title. And there were very few English or British dancers in the company that I noticed on the television. What percentage are British here, do you think?
It's just about half. And often we get asked this question, we say, why are your dancers all British? And I say, well, what about Manchester United? Are they all from Manchester? It just doesn't follow. It's an international company, and most ballet companies have dancers from all over the world.
Right.
We have a lot from the UK.
I think you should take the English bit out of the
Do you think
title.
So? International ballet.
International,
doesn't
national
sound,
ballet.
Sound
half,
half English.
Half English. No, half British.
Well, half British.
National ballet.
It doesn't really scan, though, Richard.
Katie Brand, any thoughts?
Well, I think it's like in sort of some parts of Europe, like in Germany, every major town has its own opera house and its own opera company. And so, consequently, there tend to be a lot of opera singers because children just get used to going to see that sort of thing as a matter of course. So it's probably dropped. It's become very expensive to go and watch ballet and things like that
Not ours.
Not yours.
Happily,
okay,
ours
fair enough.
Is very reasonable.
But I think as long as people go and see ballet and young children sort of see it from an early age and don't think it's something that just posh people do, then they might sort of get into it from an earlier age and then come through the ranks and then become ballet stars.
Let's have some more texts and emails. 85058. Any questions? If you love ballet, tell me why. If you hate ballet, you hate the idea of ballet. Again, just tell me why. Richard, I am a trainee PE teacher, and dance is one area of the national curriculum that is very difficult and disaffected by young boys. I believe ballet holds many positives as a teaching activity, but I feel it would be very difficult to sell to boys. How would your guests go about convincing or even starting ballet with the boys from my perspective of having no experience? So, Barnaby Meredith, who plays the older Billy Elliot, what would you say to Mike there?
I'd say they'd probably organise a trip to go and see a ballet for a start. That would be somewhere to start. Or something like Billy Elliot that's got a bit of dancing in it and a bit of, you know, the acting and all, you know, all the other stuff in it. And it's got tap dancing and everything in it. Because a lot of guys go and see these shows and then get inspired to dance. I mean, I've met people at Stage Door and I get messages sometimes on Facebook and things like that from guys that have never danced in their lives. And all of a sudden they see the show and they want to dance because they're inspired by what they see on stage and realise it's not just something for girls.
Young Billy Elliot, Scott McKenzie, what do you think? How could he go about getting young boys excited by ballet?
Yeah, I definitely think a trip to go and see a ballet would be great, because when I first went to see a ballet, it was Sleeping Beauty by Scottish Ballet, which was just amazing, and I thought it was going to be just some girls doing point work and stuff like that. But it wasn't. There was just these men doing spins in the air, and it was just brilliant to watch.
You see, this is what's good about Billy Elliot, isn't it? It's like, it's a sort of an entry-level thing, because people think, oh, I like the film, I'll go and see that musical, and then it's got a bit of ballet in there. And if you like the ballet, then maybe you go and see a full-on ballet, but a lot of people won't go straight to, I don't know, the Nutcracker or something.
Definitely.
I'll tell you something else that struck me, Craig.
What's that?
There doesn't seem to be many famous ballets. You are, it seems that you're always putting on either Swan Lake or the Nutcracker or Romeo and Juliet. Aren't there any others?
Sleeping Beauty is another one. Cinderella, Manon, Giselle. There's a lot, but I guess the most popular ones are Swan Lake, The Nutcracker, will be way ahead of all the other ballets.
You gave me a fact about the amount of people that have been to see ballet that have only seen Swan Lake. What was that
fact? It's something like 60% of all ballet audiences in the world have only ever seen Swan Lake. Isn't that extraordinary?
And your dancers here, right, sometimes they say, oh, not Swan Lake again. Come on.
No, they love it, don't you guys? Yeah, look, they're nodding. You love Swan... No, they're not nodding. No. Swan Lake brings in lots of audiences, which is really good.
I have been... This is Martin... Mostyn in Exeter, who says, I have been to the Royal Ballet at Covent Garden to see Romeo and Juliet. I love the motion, the costumes, orchestra music, set, lighting, etc. But all the way through was waiting for singing or talking to start. For me, I shall stick to opera, which does tell the story completely.
I think that's probably a fundamental misunderstanding of what ballet is.
Right.
I think probably a dictionary would come in handy.
Is there a deadly rivalry between the English National Ballet, where we are now, and the Royal Ballet? Do you hate each other?
No, is this live on the radio?
Yeah.
No, we love each other. We love each other. No, we honestly, we do get on. We all
Which is better? Which is better?
No, you can't do that. You can't do that. We all work together for ballet. I love ballet.
Is it not like the Jets and the Sharks from West Side Story?
Yeah, where a little bit, actually.
Every so often you meet in back alleys around Covent Garden and have a dance-off. Well, does that happen? Please tell me it does.
We slash their point shoes. Yeah.
Just one quick point. But guys, thank you for coming down today. It's great to see you, Scott. I hope to come and see you, both in Billy Elliot, my fifth visit there. But Scott McKenzie, a real pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Good luck. I hope you become the principal dancer that you want to one day. And Barnaby, great to see you as well.
Thank you very much.
There's Barnaby Meredith. You can go and see them both in the West End at Billy.